Good evening. I'm Sergeant Tom Letras with the Stanislaus County Sheriff's Department. This is your daily update for Tuesday, April 14th, 2020. The numbers for today are positive 163, negatives 2,540. We have 77 recovered. And sadly, today we have had two more deaths, which gets our number to four. What I want to talk about that today is that it's very clear that we are not out of the woods yet. I know many of you may have seen the press briefing today by our governor talking about starting to make plans to ease some of these restrictions. One of the things that he did say today is that a lot of the easing of restrictions is going to be predicated on us continuing to maintain our social distancing, continuing to stay at home, so that we can continue to have the numbers come in lower. What this does is this gets our medical staff time to be able to treat these as they come in, rather than everything coming at once in a surge. I know that recently we had an Easter weekend, and we got a lot of complaints here at the Sheriff's Department from large family gatherings of people who were gathering outside their homes. And one of the things we know from talking to Dr. V is that when these gatherings occur, it is typically a short period of time, it could be 7 to 10 days, before we start seeing any results from this. What that means is that families who may have gathered, if someone there was infected with COVID-19 and infected other family members, it may take a couple of days for someone to start showing symptoms. And then another day or two for them to go in to see a doctor, to get tested, to get results. So the concern would be that even though we've been doing well, we could see a spike in numbers based on the number of people who may have gathered on this Easter weekend. It's important for all of us to continue to maintain our social distancing, to continue to stay at home, to continue to stay with our families. None of us here working at the OES who are working on this COVID response live in a bubble. We all have families. Many of us have children. Some of us have loved ones that live with us who may be in at-risk categories. I can tell you that I have my 18-year-old daughter who is home from college, who's very upset because many of her friends are allowed to go out and gather together, and I have not allowed her to go out. I understand the difficulties for all of us. I understand the frustration from our youth, especially that these youth that seem that they're invulnerable because they're not getting sick. But I want to remind everybody that it's the choices we make now that could make a difference in someone else getting very sick or possibly even dying. We know that our numbers are going to continue to rise. There's nothing we can do about that. But what we can do is we can try to slow those numbers so that our hospital staff can help to treat as many people as they can. Tomorrow night, again, we are going to be having our live question and answer period, our community panel. It'll start at 5:30 on our Facebook channel right here. Our guests tomorrow night are going to be Sheriff Jeff Dirksey, Dr. Julie Weshampayan, as well as Ruben Imperial from Behavioral Health Services to talk about a lot of the mental health issues that we are seeing. We would ask that if you have any questions, you can begin sending them. You can post them right here in the post on this. We are paying attention and we are doing our best to get this information out to you. So please, again, do your best to continue. The sooner we can get through these difficult times, the sooner we can begin starting to get our lives back to normal and be able to share time with our family and friends. So thank you, and we will see you tomorrow night at 5:30 for our live Q&A.